Hello all, greetings, this is Gilles Mancier. I wanted to say hello to some greetings and blessings. I'm going to pull out a few cards. I wanted to wish you a very happy month of June, for we are moving towards the equinox, where all the energies will be in balance. For now, we are, well, let's see what the archangels may have to say. The highest wisdom for us today is the page of Ariel. It says, an excellent opportunity is offering itself to you. Study or formation, it is time to get to work. For work is can be many things, so in many sense, we want to fulfill that, to be ready to move into that opportunity. That's where the wisdom lies. What we need to understand is the Ace of Raphael. Positive experience on the emotional plane. You will be fulfilled by a romantic relationship. Let yourself be guided by your intuition. So it is the card of love, of sharing. What we need to do is the Eight of Ariel. It is, you can be proud of the work you have accomplished. It is by practicing that we learn. So it is experience that will teach us. You may think about returning to study or to learn to get a formation. So it is good to continue to here. It is very much a card about learning, studying, whatever, taking seminars, reading books, enriching ourselves in relationship to what we need to do to be really really well versed in relationship to the work we feel we need to do. And the general message for us today is the great priestess, the Archangel Eniel. She's talking about psychic perspicacity, reflection and meditation that are given, which are of great value, be in peace. So it is about paying attention to the inner voice, to our intuition, to the signs, to everything is here to give. And sometimes we allow ourselves to be distracted a little bit. I wanted to say that the first time, for those who can believe that we came from a higher realm and we chose to incarnate here on the earth, we've had many, many incarnations, and the first time we incarnated, the first time we said, I am this or I am that, a star was born and given to us. We have, so we all have our star in the universe. There is infinite number of stars in the universe, in the cosmos, As a divine counselor once said, only my father numbers the stars, and he knows them all by name. And God is the only one who knows all the stars by name and number. But we all have our own star. I've seen mine. Mine was shown to me. It is a little white star, but it's very beautiful. I'm really enjoying reconnecting to that starlight. And so we all have our star in the universe. It is a matter of reconnecting to it. For what we know in terms of stars, stars are the teachers of light, the greatest teachers of light. They are the light giver. And so, in many sense, there are stars that we know, like the sun that gives heat and light. Without the stars, there would be no life in the universe. But there are also stars that only give light, the spiritual stars that do not have this, do not need to give out heat. And so it is important to recall, to remember that you have a star in the universe. Also to understand that it's always darkest right before the dawn. For personally, I have to resolve a few things in my life, in my logistic, and so I'm going to continue to do those messages because I know they are useful, but I may have to do a little break. In many sense, I have been coming to realize that all our problems, from a higher standpoint, all our problems, sentimental, financial, social, professional, all those things looks extremely futile from the planes of light, but to us who are living in this time and space matter, they look very real. And so the key is not to allow ourselves to be too distracted, to remain stoic, to remain serene in relationship to all those things. And as we do that, it's easier to overcome things. And so one day I had the chance to. So it is very right before the light comes. It gets. It can get really dark. It's the darkest time of the night. And one day I remember I was a few years ago. I was really sick. I thought I was gonna die. And so I called on the light. And so there was a couple of experiences. And then all of a sudden, Aurora came out. Aurora is a divinity, is a goddess. I did not see her, but I saw the transition from darkness into the day, and it was such a magnificent vision. I thank her for that vision. And so I recommend you read Aurora. It's the one with the pink finger, with the curly hair. And so I did not see her in her divinity form, but I saw the experience of it. I recommend that if you haven't read it, it's the two poems of Homer. One is called L'Iliade, and the other one is called Odysseus. or Ulysses. Ulysses being the Latin name for Odysseus, for Odysseus, which is the I personally prefer the Odysseus, the travel of Ulysses than the fury of Achilles in the Iliad. But they're very essential poem, and they probably exist in audiobook, and so they're very, very essential. The most essential poet that ever lived, Homer. It's the base, the root base of all philosophy from the Greek, and the Greek philosopher is all the root base of all that we know in relationship to society, although it has evolved through times. I wanted to say also that somebody asked me a question that there may be a situation where all of a sudden you have tears that comes out of your tears that pours out and pours out and pours out, and you don't know why. But in many sense, I've been through that period many years ago. It's a cleansing. It cleans all. It is a process of cleansing all cellular memories. There is thousands of lifetimes that we have accumulated pain, and we need to release it in order to be free. So it is not to use to find chemical ways to subdue those problems, to think that there is a problem. It's no problem. Just let the process flow, if that ever happened to you. For not everybody necessarily need to do that. But I also wanted to talk about those people that are every time you meet them, they'll try to take away your joy, to put you down, to they're really like, you know, and as Socrates told us, that those people that are not kind, that are unkind, it is not their fault. It's because they do not know how to be kind, and so they have to be unkind. However, it is we do not want to give too much of our energy to those people that are really unkind. So it is important to understand what needs to be done, what doesn't need to be done. For everybody's got God presence within themselves, and so it is. So there are certain things we don't need to bug into people's life. It is their life. We got to let them live their life freely in the way they choose. So I hope this message was interesting for you. I'm going to just speak. This painting behind me is called Jerusalem. It is one of the celestial paintings. For this sphere of Jerusalem, this is the first celestial world that we'll encounter in our ascent. It is the center, administrative center, for 619 planets that are represented here and here there is the Earth, which is number 606, and so those are evolutionary worlds, when this is an invisible cluster of worlds that is a celestial architectural sphere that were created for administration of the cosmos. There is all kinds of and then this, there is 100 systems within our constellation of Norlia Tadek, which the center is called Edentia. So Jerusalem is the central world. For those worlds we could pass by, we would never see them because they're invisible, they're on a higher level. Jerusalem is 100 times bigger than the Earth, and then there is 7 clusters of worlds around it. At the center of each cluster there is a planet, it's about 10 times bigger than the Earth, and each of the 7 sub-satellites of those systems are about the size of the Earth, and those are educational spheres. They're like a school. We will have to pass through all those spheres in order to get educated, to graduate from that sphere, because before we can move on to the next level in the constellation, then we'll move on to the sphere of the local universe, and then we'll move on to the super universe, spiritual sphere, all the way to the center of the super universe, before we embark on the journey, the eternal journey of the central universe, to eventually attain this paradise status. So Jerusalem is there is those 7 clusters of world. There is a They are known as the angelic worlds, the super angelic worlds, the worlds of the sons, the worlds of the spirits, the worlds of the father, the worlds of the finaliters, and the Morantia worlds. Morantia is a matter, is a matter that intervenes between the physical matter and spiritual matter, for all beings, whether they're material or spiritual or morantial, live on physical plane. Well, you don't like live on clouds, floating clouds. So it's just a higher matter that is not subject to degradation. It is a realm that is transitory between the realm of spirit and matter. And so I hope you enjoyed this video. I thank you very much for liking, sharing, subscribing. And if you have any questions, do not hesitate. I wish you a wonderful day, a wonderful month of June, and I'll talk to you soon. Namaste.